start. He's got his kill money, so he's just fine. He even gets right back in there for an extra wave. So
yeah,
really fortunate here. Keep his minion lead after that.
That's big. And 6A, because he got the first blood kill, he got a pickaxe on the recall, makes it much easier to knock his turret down. Demolitionist Tristana.
Doublelift would have thought he's recalled by
Ward,
this point.
They have Ward seeing this.
They're going for it. Going for the play. The slow is landed, but now Yellowstar's going to tank this one up with the shield in front. Flash prayer, but there's the flank. The double TP yet again for Counter Logic Gaming in game 5. You can't write it any better than this.
Talk about focusing all resources into Stixxa here. CLG show up with everybody, all hands on deck in the top lane. That does mean that TSM can push out the other lane,
yeah,
but that's not going to be enough.
There's pressure on the other lanes, but it's so early, and it does seem like CLG could run down. What a beautiful play once again by CLG. They have been calling TSM again and again and punishing them for their decisions. Doublelift is not having a good time, and the rage play Trist is coming.
Early lead here for Tristana, and she can start it off.
Yeah, both people teleporting onto the same board. Not that it really matters. TSM was pretty dead.
I mean, it's technically their signature move now.
Yeah. CLG doesn't like them.
Yeah, they do it almost every game now.
I think it's the time.
TSM knew it was there. There was already a Caitlyn trap under that trinket ward. Like, they saw it get put down. I was like, guys, they can TP flank this.
Yeah.
And Double still walked up. I got rocket jumped on. Rough stuff here.
Yeah.
CLG with a sizable lead now, 2,000 gold up, and all the pressure to try to get Stixxa ahead is certainly happening. There's the blasting one. It is going to be Rageblade.
Yep.
Darshan also, though, 3-0 with 6 stacks and a Dark Seal.
Yeah, that's a huge thing. We say it's been top lane focus up towards Stixxa, but Darshan has been the beneficiary of so much of this. The attempted counter jungle by Svenskeren gave him the double buffs. That double TP gave him 2 more kills, so he's been the one with the largest gold advantage over his opponent. 1,200 gold ahead of Haunter already.
1,200 gold and 6 stacks on the ring.
Mm-hmm. That added value.
Yeah. All right, well, Haunter's got to try to lick those wounds and keep up as close as he can despite his giant gold deficit. Bjergsen farming up as well as he can on the Corki.
Yeah. TSM now in that mode where everyone just says, okay, relax, farm for late, because they're in a pretty big hole right now. They don't want to force the issue. Just try and see if they can grab some farm and wait it out, try and punish some mistakes. Maybe CLG will overstep, and they can use the package. That is a big playmaking ability as far as countering CLG initiation.
Afro tries to save the pink ward, can't really do so. Yellowstar knocks that one down. Rageblade completed for Stixxa.
And it is times like these where, as the team that is behind, you need to focus on where you were still ahead. Bjergsen has 100 CS in the mid lane. When he is Trinity Force, he should look to make a play. And even though Svenskeren hasn't had successful ganks, he's been farming really hard. And once he completes his Devour, looking to get kills and stack up the Devour that way would be TSM's best way back into the game.
Yeah, I mean, Svenskeren's got a 2-level lead over Smithy because of the focus that Smithy has been putting on the bottom lane.
He's not farming. You gotta keep that in mind, what can be done. Right now, Svenskeren at only 1 Kindred mark and about 1 Devourer stack after this camp. He just completed the item, so this is his first.
Far for late, boys.
Sven is gonna be one of the bigger people in this game. He's actually got more gold than either his top laner or his AD carry right now, so this is the man to really watch for physical damage output. Triple Marksman TSM with 2 tanks in the front. And one of these marksmen getting denied, the other 2 doing okay.
Yeah, but with the 2 tanks in the front, they are going to get run over if they can't catch up in this game.
Yes.
Yellowstar is 0-2. Haunter is most likely going to get outpaced heavily by Darshan once Darshan starts completing some of these items. So really it's Svenskeren who needs to be able to get some of those tanks back in the game if they want to set up standard teamfight lines.
There's 5 Sated stacks right there for Sven.
That's big. That'll definitely help.
Feels good.
7.
Yep. Now, it's also worth keeping in mind, any sort of Rageblade build does have a falloff. You're not getting that same sort of crit synergy that an Infinity Edge Hurricane would. So, in terms of getting through those big, beefy tanks, Stixxa is going to need more gold than he would have otherwise on Caitlyn to actually make that sort of damage pacing happen.
It's also going to be a fair bit of magic damage coming out of CLG. Like, with the Pix damage that goes on top of Stixxa, the itemization would be fairly heavily tilted towards being magic. Makes it a little easier for the tanks to itemize.
A little damage to Aphromoon. Doesn't seem to care too much, though, as he just triumphantly roars and puts his health back up. And look at the damage output here. Chunk goes the turret. And that will be two outer turrets now for CLG, putting that Tristana in a lane that she can kill a turret with and using that to balloon a mid-game lead.
Chunk. Her like a demolitionist.
Like a demolitionist. I said that earlier. Don't worry. I got you covered
so
up.
So quickly. And it's because they always have the proper jungle pressure with them. It's cost X-Smithy 30 CS, but it's winning them the game. In a meta where jungle farming is so heavily valued, X-Smithy has kind of flipped the script once again and just totally camped a lane. But because his ganks have been successful, you see why people used to do that style so frequently.
Right, of course.
Because it can still work very well.
And he found the right players to gank for, of course. The flash pulverize for the first blood and then the double TP into the top side afterwards. But definitely some good plays here. We'll see how much more CLG can get out of this one. Pink Ward's once again added to their inventories. As who he is down a bit, but not insurmountably so in this mid lane matchup, farm-wise. Smithy also with a very utility-focused build once again, going for the Tracker's Knife, also finishing Boots of Lucidity before getting into the completed jungle enchant. Really valuing summoner spell cooldowns and just cycling his CC in general. Zerker's Greaves in the beginning of a Hurricane now coming in for Stixxay. So again, a very attack speed on hit focused build.
Yeah. Now, what I'd like to see here from CLG is to get the push priority in their side lanes first and then turn their attention towards this mid lane. They're the ones with the Alistar this time. They're the ones with the AD carry who's spiking now, whereas Caitlyn's trying to build crit. But GSM have already moved double up into the mid lane to wave clear and try and set up traps and dissuade them from that strategy. Spence Garen also making his appearance.
Afro showing himself as well, but doesn't quite get tagged too terribly low. Down to half HP, cutting away from the wolf, and he's going to be okay here. But there's always going to be the risk of a big play happening. Trinity Force down, Corki, and the risk of explosive cast can always stay in your mind. Once again, Afro getting pushed around. Doing doesn't mean too much on a Svenskeren. Darshan also is not really pushing any kind of a lead. For having three kills, he's got the minion wave pushed up, but he's not getting a farm lead over Hanser.
And that is kind of what I was looking for in the mid game here, but Boogie also has the bottom line in a decent position. Teleports are both ready. But if CLG misstep and they go for a dive and they throw it at the dive, they botch this, TSM gets right back in this game. Kindred snowballs like hell.
Yeah. 18 stacks now on Devourer, 2 stacks for Mark of the Kindred.
Definitely still farming hard. I feel like CLG can really turn it on once Stixxay gets his Hurricane. That's going to be, I think, their highest point of power. Huhi on 2 items, Stixxay on 2 items. And it will be Darshan, about half an item to a full item ahead of Monster. And even though CLG has a lot of opportunity to split push, if they just grouped and shoved once they hit those power spikes, I think they take full control.
Looking for the play right now. Echo Stun comes in and explosive charge onto the turret. Knocks it down to about 2/3 here. You can see that as long as they're given those 4 seconds to auto attack, CLG can get some meaningful damage on that.
Oh yeah, package came in. So yeah. Good job by CLG backing off there.
And a few recalls come in as well. Both Elise and Alistar heading back to the base to grab their new items. Completed upgraded Sightstone now for Aphromoo. Eye of the Equinox is in.
Yeah,
like the ward control game.
And we also have to remember, this is the highest pressure game. It's game 5 of the finals with the championship on the line. So the normal play patterns can't necessarily be fully relied upon, right? Like, you can't expect a perfectly played closeout. You're going to see either people being more conservative or more risky depending on how they respond to the pressure. So far, TSM needs to be conservatively smart, not too scared, but willing to pull the trigger. One of the hardest things to do when you're under this much pressure in a game 5 and facing a deficit. Whereas CLG needs to be able to pull the trigger at the right time.
Yes. CLG have to make plays that have risks. You can't play League of Legends with zero risk. Just, you won't win games unless you're significantly better than your opponents. So it's up to which ones they're willing to take, which choices they'll make. 2,500 gold still keeps CLG in the lead as the gold keeps stacking up. 1,800 gold in the inventory of Stixxay right now. Also, Svenskeren still stacking up as well. 23 on Devourer,
3 on Mark of the Cooter. Now into the bot lane. The push towards Huhi. The flash comes in. The knockout's going to land. How long can Lulu live? Self-ult. And getting stunned again. And Bjergsen gets the kill.
Teleport in, though. It's just not done.
It's not done, but it's a 4v5. Let's see what CLG can do.
CLG is all here.
Getting pushed around. Darshan getting hit up as well. How much can they gain from this one? The headbelt pulverize comes in for 2. Here's Stixxay. But here comes Svenskeren. Ulti back from Ekko. And TSM are back in. They're looking for Darshan. They're going to get Darshan. A shutdown for Svenskeren. 2 kills for TSM. And the chase continues. A bit more damage on the minions. CLG are routed.
That's exactly the type of play TSM was waiting for. Who he pushes up in the split. There is no one to defend him, and Yellowstar and Bjergsen are willing to go all in, flashing, ulting, finishing the kill.
TSM are right back in this. Here comes the teleport from CLG, though.
Looking for the cocoon, not gonna land, though. Huhi's teleport meant absolutely nothing, and even still, it's only a 4v5. Darshan's still dead. Hanser jumps over the wall. He's gonna be totally fine on this one. CLG are in position for the dragon, so hey, gold's still 1,300 apart. And the first dragon now for CLG. TSM got one earlier, but this influx of stats will be nice. All said and done, 2 kills for TSM, 1 dragon for CLG.
Yeah, definitely more interesting now after that set of events, though, with the dragons being even, the gold being much more close.
Yeah.
Got a nice little sneak up and pretty much at the max range of Q. And I love how he flashed forward to get the ultimate and allow Bjergsen to finish off the kill.
Yeah, I'm actually curious why he went over towards that brush. Maybe he thought he had a ward and did not. Anyways, here's the answer, teleports.
And here CLG was here a lot before TSM was, so that's why Darshan is feeling so confident, but Bjergsen's able to dodge a lot of the damage and the rest of it would just be right onto TSM's tanks.
Yeah, Darshan also ults out of the shield, doesn't quite get the stun, and still gets knocked back in. Split second.
Suboptimally played team fight. He loses a lot of the Dark Seal stacks he had obtained.
And I think Stixxay hadn't bought yet as well. I mentioned 1,800 gold beforehand. I don't think he had bought. Now he's got the Hurricane, though, so that's a big power spike. 2 items in for the CLG 80 carry. Now a team fight would look a little bit better, but yeah, it wasn't what it was before.
Despite losing 2 kills, I still think CLG should group right here. The package, as well as the pick potential of the Gragas, is kind of what TSM wants, even though CLG is so comfortable in the 1-3-1. The grouping of Trist and Lulu was just so strong.
Yeah, that was a teamfight, but it was a teamfight without the Lulu, who he was dead on arrival. We'll see if it looks better next time. 29 stacks on Svenskeren's Devourer now. He just got 2 up the scuttle, so next camp he finds gives him that sated. Okay, Yellowstar does not have Flash, gets Wimby, but look at the damage on a Huhi. Ulti popped in, dodged away. Look at the damage on a Stixxay, though. Doesn't get blocked by Afromu. The Owls are forced to run. Chowning Smite is on. True damage still taking in from Svenskeren. Huhi looking for the play, and Bjergsen dodges the Glitter Lance, though. And Elise repelling away.
As Rift Herald spawns.
Actually re-engaging on the Hanser on this side, but it's tank-on-tank action.
CLG got heavily poked out. Hanser doesn't pull the trigger on the explosive cast, but CLG lost that fight. They've got to recall several members here.
You can feel they're losing a little bit of the confidence. Everybody's starting to get a little jittery here.
Yeah.
After that last team fight.
TSM know with those 2 kills picked up, they're going to feel much better. That included shutdown gold from killing out the formerly 3-0 Darshan.
Yellowstar blocking away and walking out of this one, but now the turret is under fire. CLG staying around. The deep stun comes out and it will force TSM back, and finally another turret comes through. CLG up 3 turrets to 0.
Now it's on them to set up these wards. Try and find TSM as they're moving between their own jungle. Svenskeren's been constantly cleaning his own jungle, just back and forth. CLG are in the position to get those deeper wards and cut them off.
Yeah, he hit sated as well 21 minutes in, so got a little bit before then. The triple marksman in the fight is very respectful DPS.